Good morning, everybody. Welcome to All Psyched Up. I'm Dr. Brooklyn Storm, Director and Head Psychologist here at the practice. And this morning I'm running a little bit late because we just got detained with one of the little munchkins who was having a little bit of trouble getting motivated to go to school today. So I thought that could be the topic of today's video, how to help your child with school transition, because that's right, they're all coming back from school, they're all getting a little bit nervous. Who are they going to sit next to? Who are they going to play with? Hey Tess, how you going? So I thought it might be helpful to sort of sit down today and have a quick chat about what's behind some of the school refusal that some of the mums and dads are experiencing from their little ones at the moment. So anxiety, as you might remember, is being afraid of something. So if your child is experiencing a little bit of school anxiety, what we want to do is try and understand what it is they're concerned about. So certainly keeping the line of communication open with your little one about what their fears are can help you understand that a little bit better and then tackle it sort of head on. So one of the things, good morning James, one of the things that some of the children are a bit nervous about is going up to the next class when some of their friends are not going to be in the same class as them. So they don't know who they're going to be hanging out with, they don't know who's going to be playing with them at recess and snack, they don't know who's going to be sitting next to them for activities and things like that. Some of them haven't even met their teacher yet because they're away for all sorts of different reasons and things like that. So for some of the kids, it's more around fear of the unknown, you know, what's going to happen. And so there are some simple things that as mums and dads you might want to try. So one strategy that works really well is if you do know a parent of a child that's going to be in class with yours, you can certainly arrange a play date prior to school or a play date after school so children can get to know each other. Something else you might want to try is organising for your little one to meet their friend at the school gate. That way they can walk into school together. Doing things like that is usually quite helpful because it also serves to distract your little one from what it is they're worried about. Organising to spend time at the school outside of school hours can also help because it makes the school environment a little bit more familiar, and this reduces some of the fear around the unknown as well. Our behaviourist Shoshana has said in our kids page that it's really helpful for parents to just keep in mind that routine is essential at this time of the year. You know, kids are already going through a transition, so it's really helpful if we make sure that everything that's going on at home is nice and consistent, because we know a good level of healthy predictability keeps the little ones nice and calm too. So there's some tips on managing school refusal for this week, but if you have any questions, of course you're most welcome to send me a private message. In other news, just wanted to let you know we've had some really exciting developments at the practice. So we've got a new dietitian, her name's Jessica, she's on board, and we also have Alicia joining us. Alicia is a she works with energy, she does energy healing and sound healing. So they're both going to be available from the next 2 weeks, and we'll move over to the new practice on the 1st of March. But they'll be available to take appointments soon. We're also recruiting. We've got an interview at in about 10 minutes for a male psychologist to join the practice. He's specialising in men's behaviour programs and anger, and he works with single dads and all that sort of jazz, so that'd be really cool. We're also meeting another counsellor this afternoon. She's got another interest in also yoga, so she's wanting to sort of see how she might be able to mix the yoga with psychotherapy for clients who might be interested in that, and do some mindfulness workshops down the beach, because as you know, let me just turn the camera around so you can see. This is where we are. So we're kind of up on top of the world here. So that's the beach over there, of course, McDonald's. Looking up in that direction over there is Mount Eliza. That's where Mum lives. Hi, Mum. And if we go looking all the way down this side down there, just down past that big tree there, that's where the new practice is. Still nice and close to the water and everything else. Anyway, I hope you all have a really wonderful day today. I'm going to get going now, get ready for this interview, so excited. And I look forward to seeing everybody on our group page as well. I can't believe the numbers just exploded over there. please, if you haven't voted in the poll yet, do go and vote. Let me know what time's going to suit you so that we can do some lives. You can all join in and have lots of fun. Thank you so much, Tess, for all love hearts. That's very nice. Hi, Renee. Hi, Amit. Hi, Tracy. I hope you all have a beautiful morning this morning. I'm off now. See you later. Bye.